secure.
Really? What a little prick spider. Oh my god, I hate these things. I hate him, I hate him, I hate him. Oh, what, you gonna run because I killed your bitch ass homie? Good news, everyone! Part 9 saved. So that means you're watching part 10 because you also watched part 9, and you now know that part 9 was up because it got uploaded, and everything's all good. And there's some dust men shooting me up, and I'm just gonna ignore them because, quite frankly, don't like them. They're not worth it. I'm ready to move on to the next level. And just now saying that reminded me of Tekken when you're, I don't know what mode it is or something, or if it's just the standard arcade or what have you, but you'll be playing it and then it will be like, you'll knock out a fighter and then it will be like, get ready for the next battle, or get ready for the next fight, or something like that, along those lines. And I don't even remember what Tekken it was. I think it's Tekken 6. That is the most recent one. And they actually just announced Tekken 7, which is awesome, because it's one of the few fighting games I can actually enjoy. I know, I'm crazy, but I'm not really a fighting game fan. To be honest, I kind of like, fucking hate fighting games. I just don't, I mean, like, I get it if, you know, other people like it or whatnot, but for me, dude, I play one fight in every single fighting game, and I'm like, I've seen all the content in this game already. It's like, oh, other fighters, other stages, but, like, seriously, it's, like, mechanically just so blah to me. Like, one fight, and it's like, okay, that's it. It's a game of 2-minute bursts, because that's how long fights usually even last in most fighting games. It's just like, I can't do it for more than, like, that's just so, like, too repetitive for me. Like, I just do one fight and I'm like, I've seen everything this game has already. I just can't do it. I can't do it. And I have friends that love fighting games and they'll play like thousands of fights and I'm like, oh my god, I just don't fucking get it. Like, oh my lord. Over and over and over again. And people would like to make the argument of, oh, well, you know, a shooting game, it's shooting over and over again, or a racing game, it's racing all over and over and over. No, no. Like, it's one static screen where you can barely move anywhere except fight one dude and then it's over. Like, racing, there's multiple tracks, and, you know, you can move your car all across the course and everything, and, you know, a shooting game, of course, that's not linear, like, you can move everywhere, and it's just like, you're so confined to one thing, you know, like, it's too boring for me. But let's start this mission. Terrorized streets. I'm talking over this dialogue right now. But it looks like a bus. Looks like it's shooting stuff. Guess we're gonna do something about it. Not sure what. I actually don't know what to do. I think you gotta get on the top of them. Because, if you get anywhere close to that thing's going to fuck you up. And it has turrets on it, and we all know how much I hate turrets. So this is one of those things where you got to jump on top. Dismantle it from there. There we go. I don't know how to stop it, though. The voltage. Did you get off it?
Yeah. Eat it.
Oh, no, you don't have to get off it. You just blow it up from there. Oh, my God, this BK that I had and all this coke I drank, like, it's just making me, like, burp now all of a sudden. I'm trying to hold them back as a courtesy to you all. Don't want to sound too much like a gross, disgusting pig, but that's exactly what I am. So despite the fact that I'm trying to hide it, I'm admitting it to you.
Helping out the cops. You kidding me? I thought you hated cops.
I like you said, things have changed. Besides, any lawman that stayed in this hellhole is the real deal. Gotta respect that. I'll catch you later.
Ah, see, there you go. Some cop love from Zeke. Good on you, Zeke. Good on you. The other night, I got really addicted to this website. And I already forgot the fucking name to it. Ah, shit on a stick. I gotta get out of here. Oh, no. Whew. Anyway, I got really addicted to this site. It's like job something or whatever. But basically, it's a community site where you can go there either as a person answering questions or just wanting to see questions get answered. And it's like I'm a mailman. Ask me a question. And then you can read a bunch of questions that a real mailman answered, and it's all these questions where it's like, you always think to yourself, like, hey, I wonder what this specific person has to deal with, or I wonder what happens throughout the day-to-day operations of being this specific person. And that's kind of what the website is, so I read a cop's profile. Like, the guy was like, hey, I'm a cop, I've been a cop for, you know, 30 or so years, blah, 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 ask me whatever you want. And there was like 1,000 questions this cop got, and like, you know, they're all very interesting questions, some random ass shit you'd never think, or, you know, it gives you a really, like, a better perspective what these people do on a day-to-day basis. Like, a really in-depth perspective, because it's the internet, and, you know, it's questions, it's written, you know, content, it's a lot more thorough than, say, what a documentary can show you or whatever, despite a documentary or television being able to show footage to you. But really can't be more in-depth when you're looking into 1,000 questions being asked to this guy. So I was, like, up all night reading questions that this cop got, and it was really interesting stuff. Although for the cop, it was kind of boring because it was the internet, a lot of people were asking very state-specific questions, and the guy was like, depends on your state, because they were asking a lot of law questions, like, you know, what happens in this scenario and whatnot, and Jesus Christ, this bus is, like, nowhere near a rooftop. It's getting annoying at this point. My rat's drinking water. I'm sure you can hear that in the audio. Yeah, listen to that. That is some cutting-edge audio right there of a rat drinking water out of his water bottle. Okay, now we're on top. And the thing about that website was, it was one of those sites where it's like, dude, I know I'm going to spend... Oh, shit. I'm just going to walk right by you. Anyway, it was one of those websites where I knew I could easily spend my whole week... like every night, 4 hours a night, just reading this website, because it's really interesting stuff, and I really like learning, you know, new shit and whatnot, and, you know, it is one of those really cool websites that you can get lost in, so I knew I was gonna get lost in it, so I did my fucking best to stay away from that website, and I actually did, quite good. I just can't waste that much time, but, like, I can't control myself with that stuff. If I get too interested in something, I'm just going to get lost in it. And the first night I found it, it's exactly what happened. And I needed to go to sleep that night, too, because I had to get up early in the morning. So I knew, okay, maybe I shouldn't go back to that site for a while until I know I really do have some, like, free time. But I read the cop's profile. I read a casino dealer's profile. So he's like, hey, I'm a casino dealer. Ask me questions. I was reading his... And then I read, a zoo person's for, like, a little bit. Not much. But I read hers. And they were like, what's the most dangerous thing that could happen to, a zoo? And she's like, well, obviously all the animals, like, escaping. And the, you know, follow-up question she got was like, what is, like, the procedure for that or whatnot? And she's like, dangerous animals are always first. So you have to consider, like, you know, lions and, like, elephants and shit. It's like, fuck the small shit, basically. Birds are birds, like, fuck them and whatnot. She didn't actually use the vulgar language that I used, but you get the idea. Wow. I'm taking an extremely long time to finish this mission. Oh, that's good. Now you can hear my rat tearing cardboard. Well, this is excellent. Can you hear that? Yeah, that's my rat tearing cardboard. Now let me explain to you why he's tearing cardboard. Or more so, why there's cardboard in his cage. The cage I bought is from Critter Nation, or Ferret Nation, I think. And it's an excellent cage, I like it a lot. But the problem with it is, it doesn't have any guards on the bottom, like near the the bottom level. It has no guards against the wall, so all his little poopy poops fall out of the tank, fall out of the cage. So what I did was I lined the inside of it with cardboard. And I did the inside specifically because if I line the outside of it, the poop is only going to get stuck. And then when I have to clean the cage and, like, take out the bottom pan, the poop's just still going to fall on the floor. So I had to put it on the inside and slant it, like, on top of the bottom pan. You see what I'm saying? That way, no poop leaves and I can easily, like, deposit the rest of them. And that strategy obviously works, but the rats, and rats like to chew and they like to gnaw and stuff, so they naturally gnaw and chew and peel away at the cardboard, which is kind of self-defeating because you'd think, okay, well, they're gonna destroy all the cardboard and you just gotta put new cardboard in there. And not really, they rarely chew it, which is surprising because right now my rat's chewing it and it's ruining the video. Now, let's face it, this fucking thing was ruined when I started it. Oh, self-degrading comedy. It's the best, isn't it? Nah, I think I do a good job here, don't you think? Well, on this YouTube channel, as a total. Oh my god, you blew the sign up! I was gonna use this as a vantage point! Why can't I get up this sign? Oh, you fucking bastards. Ah, it's not high enough. Jesus Christ! These fucking dustmen, dude. They're so annoying. I was never this fucking annoyed with Infamous because my first playthrough, like, I was going for 100%, so I was, like, destroyed, like, I was taking over all the territories. And once you take over all the territories, you never have to deal with fucking Dustman or nothing. But now that I'm not doing that, you know, there's still Dustman everywhere, so it's freaking annoying. There we go. Look at all these fucking dustmen. Like, holy shit. Like, fuck off, guys. Can't you see I'm speaking to an audience of roughly 800 people a week? Assuming all 800 views I usually get for Let's Plays are unique views. As in, it's one new one and not repeats. Because why the fuck would you click on this twice? Why would you watch this twice? Don't do that. Hey guy watching my videos twice. Don't watch them twice. I was snorting snot right there, if you couldn't tell. I'm probably not going to edit that out because I was explaining it to you. So if I removed it and then you hear me explaining it, that wouldn't make much sense, would it? I'm leaning in a very weird way. What'd she say the next mission was? Because I kind of forgot already. Poor memory. Short-term memory. A lot of popping going on this game. This is kind of a game that did not age well technically, from a technical standpoint. I think I mentioned this to somebody in the comments that said this game looked good, and I wasn't sure if he was being sarcastic or not, because even when this game came out, it just did not really look that hot. Just, you know, compared to, like, all the other games in its time, there were much better games coming out. And, even from an open-world sort of perspective, there were way better open-world games that were out. And again, this is, like, from a visual, technical standpoint. We're in the prison, don't know what I need to do yet. I do know she said it was supposed to be in the prison, but I just don't know what we're doing in regards to being in the prison. But I think this is going to be one of those big shootout things. Like a big, big hullabaloo mission where it's like, oh, shit about to go down, Betty. Shit about to go down, Shenandra. Shenandra, get your ass up there, Cole. Where the fuck is this mission? It's on the outside of the prison, isn't it? I don't need to be in this prison, do I? I have a feeling that mission is on the outside of the prison, and I don't actually need to be in here. Yep, that's exactly right. So I have to leave the prison, and then get back in it. Oh my god, I hate these fucking things so much. Get out of the bus stop, dude. Really? What a little prick spider. Oh my god, I hate these things. I hate him. Oh, what, you gonna run because I killed your bitch ass homie? Alright, let's do this. So I'm supposed to defend the prison so Alden doesn't get out. If I'm correct. Get out there, dude. Hey, water again. Dehydrated rats, that's what we're talking about. You know, I've got two rats. One's asleep right now, being a good little boy, because it's nighttime. And then the other rat is just running all over the place. He's drinking, he's tearing cardboard, he's...
The boys in blue need to move some lobs to a more secure area of the prison. Gotta hold off the trash baggers while they make the move.
What the hell is a lop?
A prisoner, man. You know, a shank holder. Come on, give it the lingo. Oh, and check it out. That walkway up there is cracking with juice. Little thing I whipped up.
Wow, thanks.
You're damn right.
Fucking right, dude. That means I'm gonna... gonna abuse the shit out of this. Keep what off you? Oh. I guess I should go over there and shoot him back? Is it this fence I'm protecting? Jesus! Well, I gotta... Maybe I shouldn't talk during this. I gotta keep focused here. Oh, I'll fuck this up. I'm apparently already at heavily damaged. Shit just started. Jesus, this is not good. If you wanna be my lover, you gotta get with my friends. Something easy, but that's the way it is. I don't know the lyrics.
Got all the mobs moved over to the new cell block. That was good work, brother.
Thank you. Uh
oh. Hell. Zeke, get out of here. Run. Don't worry, man. These guys will kill you. Go help the cops lock down all
of them. How the fuck did I not kill any of them? Is my aim that bad, or is this, like, electrical bolt just really slow? Aw, dude! Not cool. Blew up my electrical fence thing. I have to fucking bio-leech some of these dudes. I'm out of electricity. Ah, good thing about Infamous, man. There's electricity, like, everywhere. Oh, that fucking guy again. Oh, shit. I want to at least get rid of all the little dudes first. So I can focus on the big dude. Unless little dudes keep spawning until the big dude's taken care of.
Just be ready, Zeke. You can't let them get
hold of it. I'm on it, brother.
Jesus. Dude, this fucking golem has a hard-on for me. Do you see this guy? He just keeps walking after me. Like, there's thousands of other dudes around here right now. Yeah, fuck your arm, you asshole. Yeah, what are you gonna do now, dude? What are you gonna do now? Don't die, Ryan. Don't die, 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 don't die. I don't want to die. I don't want to die. If I die, then that would really suck. I'm addicted to watching Who Wants to Be a Millionaire on YouTube again. Did I talk about that in the last recording session? Because I'm still watching it. I love looking up people's runs on YouTube. By runs, I mean, you know, like one individual's run on the show. Yeah, fucking asshole. Ow! I get it. Yeah, we got a boys in blue on the turret now. Alright, I need to go get to a... What do I need to get to? Over here? No. Up here? Because it's no longer level if I'm up here. But the camera was pointing up there, wasn't it? So that's where I need to go. Am I right about that, or am I wrong about that? I'm just gonna keep... Okay. Yeah, I guess I am going up here. Oh, I am definitely going up here. Where there's enemies, there's the right way to go. Video game logic, people, if you don't know that. It's always one of those things. I'm sure everyone's been there. I don't know where to go. I don't know where to go. I don't know where to go. You find enemies. This is probably where I need to go. How do I get up there? Don't you have to grab one of those wires, which I'm trying to do, and it's not letting me? Or this? Wow, that would make more sense. Look at me, I can adapt to situations quicker than I usually would. Oh, we got a whole thing going on here. We are so Nathan Drake right now. Boy, wouldn't it be funny if I died and I had to go back, like, really far? Like, really, really far. Oh, no, grab the pipe. It's a nice little gimme shard right there. Oh, and I got a new little node out of it. Or a battery core. Good lord, this is high up. This is not the highest point in the game, though. There's a tower in the third island that's the highest point in the game. Another gimme shard. Oh, another gimme shard! It's Christmas, boys. I'm unwrapping everything. I'm coming. No, I'm not. Get your ass up there, Cole. Oh, there's so many fucking trash men. Fucking trash men. I don't even call you dust men. You're trash men. Even though your trash men make a pretty good living. I mean, consider what they do, you know? I'll tell you, man, that's one of those blue-collar jobs that pays a lot. You shouldn't have any shame in being a garbage man, because you're making that money. Please don't shoot me while I'm trying to go over here. Now what do I do? Oh, these are just little recharge plates for me. I'm gonna snipe. Aw, dude, that's crazy. Look at them all, like, light up. Oh, look at all that EXP, though. Sorry I'm not talking as much, but I'm trying to take care of some business here, people. You know what I'm saying? It's always fun when games are super easy and you can just fucking have a fucking blast. There we go. Fuck you guys. Dude, that was mad snipe. Oh, you can just probably keep going. You don't even have to recharge, probably. Yeah, you don't, because you're sitting on the thing. You can just keep going. I did not know that. I thought you had to keep... Like, because the plate was here, I thought, okay, well, you have to keep recharging. Like, it's a free recharge, but you do have to keep recharging. I didn't know you could just sit here and keep doing this. Well, that's awesome, dude. I did not know that. It's fucking sweet, dude. Yeah, fuck you. Oh, dude, this is awesome. I so did not know that. I don't even think I knew that when I originally played this, like, how many years ago? Oh my god, it's a bloodbath, dude. I'm getting so much EXP, too. We can go shopping after this. And not like Macy's shopping, like power shopping. Oh shit. Listen here, buddy. I'd like to see you try. Oh, this is awesome. Dude, I'm fucking murdering this thing. Look at how zoomed in it is. A lot of jaggies. Holy shit. Oh, just fucking peppering this guy. Fucking seasoning him. How'd you like that pepper on your risotto, fuckface? Am I supposed to keep fighting? Is there a reason why they keep respawning, or is this like... Oh, dude, I'm looking at my audio right now. It's all fucked up. Is my audio okay? That's gonna really suck if my audio's fucked up. 4, what have we, I don't got 4 minutes. Oh, another one. That was great. That's great. Dude, I'm looking at my audio right now, and, like, the waveforms are super, super, oh, there's two of them. Well, that's good. The waveforms are super, super huge. I hope my audio's not, like, totally fucked up right now. If it is, then I'm assuming I'm gonna put up, like, a little disclaimer in text, saying, hey, my audio's fucked up, sorry guys. Because clearly I'm not going to re-record all this. My god, if this is fucked up, dude, and I really hope it isn't, like... Like, goddamn, this, like, infamous Let's Play has been a technical disaster so far. Good lord, aw, man, I fucking creator anxiety. I really hope it's not fucked up. Now I keep looking at the waveforms to make sure they're okay. Oh no, it looks fine now. For some reason, when I stayed silent, the waveforms were still, like, really big, which means there's a lot of fucking background noise. And I know there's not much going on in my room right now because I turned off my air purifier, my fish tank, and everything. So I should be good here. And right now, the actual gameplay has devolved into a really zoomed in light show, basically. So I really hope you're enjoying... the dropped frame rate, me tapping R1, and a zoomed in look at this golem dude, and me constantly zapping him, because that's really what it's all come down to.
It was too late. Place was slick with gore. Poor bastards never got any backup. If Zeke kept his post, they'd be alive now. And Alden would still be in a cage. Not sure Zeke's ever gonna forgive himself for this. Don't know that he should. That night, we could hear the screams from Tent City. They were drunk on power, proud of their victory over the cops and over me. Now the race sphere seems farther away than ever. Alden knows we're coming. He'll prepare.
Before any dialogue starts, because I know it's going to, I'll end this part of the Let's Play. So thank you all for watching. This is part 10, and I'll see you all in the next one.